let's move on.
I told you, I've changed it. Instead of doing the boring part to show the result, I started showing the result, and now I think you understand a little bit better what I'm going to explain. Why here? You can think in gaming, but you can think in engaging people, making things interact, and this is very useful for museums. If you make this kind of thing for museums, you can engage people and you can show things that people don't expect at the very first beginning. In our case, we also made it just for research, to realize how it was and if it makes sense according to the data that we have. We use it for both goals at the same time. What has in the game? As you know, a game is a kind of entertainment thing, but when you use gaming techniques and game theory, in this case serious games, you try to do something else, like learn or this kind of stuff. There's a lot of different purposes. Every game has rules. All of us have played hide and seek, I suppose, and you know there are rules. If it's not challenging, it's boring. So if you design a game thinking that there have been a challenge, and if there is a purpose, better. In serious games, there is a purpose. When you create a game, first of all, the story, that's quite important. If you are going to be the user, the player, you have to realize there is a context inside. In our game, as you see, there was a poorly timed traveler that you see that he was picking things, that there is a lot of objects from the present that travel to the past with our victim, with our guy. And you have to get rid of these objects, otherwise they are anachronical. So that's the challenge. He has to find all the objects in a period of time, otherwise he don't get the reward at the end. One of the learning elements, identify. If you think in 10 years kids, they can learn how the trees was, how the ancient object was, and he have to distinguish which one are from 21st century and which of them was 4,500 years before. That's kind of boring. In games theory, you can make things simple and you can go harder and harder, but more challenging. When you design a game, aesthetics, you say, okay, I have the story, I know which are the goals, but I need something to make people engage with the game. So that's why aesthetics is very important. In our case, La Draga, we hire a professional game, otherwise these landscapes will be horrible. And with informatics like me, most probably I put just a road and everything is done. You need a person who knows how to make it really nice. The quality is very important, otherwise you don't get the engage from people. Mechanics. You have seen something. I told you, teleporting. With the cabins that you have used, and this one was quite big, was about 15 square meters, but usually are not so big. So I can go in another place, so I need to teleport to point when I want to go, and when I disappear from the place I am to the other one. At the beginning it's quite strange, but you get comfortable very easy. Using grabbing. With your handle, you grab the objects and okay, you make the move. The system reacts in consequence. In this game, the objects are randomly laid. Otherwise, the game is kind of silly. Always in the same place. I make two games.
No, okay, it's boring.
You see no obstacles. In this case, offering an amount of time and some kind of reward. All the games have this kind of mechanics, it's not new. The idea of gaming is how the games work. Okay, I make it in another tools, but the ideas below are exactly the same. Boring part, if someone wants to go out, they are free to do. There are gaming engines. Maybe you don't know exactly what is, but people don't code, don't make the game from zero. Like you have frameworks, for instance, Word facilitates you to make documents. The gaming engines facilitate you to make games. So this is made in Unity, which is one of the most famous. Indeed, there are real 3D or real 4D, and Unity are the unique gaming engines. And the glasses and the handles here is a brand. Again, boring part. How do you develop a game? It's like making software. You usually don't make it. You have to develop, integrate, you have to validate things go exactly as you expect, of course, and you have to refine. You started with a landscape which is not only boring, but say, oh my gosh, I want to go up from here. And at the end you have something which is really nice. Okay. And it's a long time, eh? You need a long time to do that. And we are thinking in the next step, of course. Bring life to Draga, more animals, more interaction, more challenge. Computer, we also use the word missions, but more challenge, more points, even though there are 3D, there are VR, virtual reality games, which you can play cooperative. Two people with the glasses are in the same scenario and they can play together. For kids, it's the best. The kids kill to get two glasses and play together. And that's all. Thank you for suffering me. And if you have any questions, feel free.